See, for formula, we need to know first that how to start the formula. Okay. So for starting formula, we use equal to, plus sign, and minus sign. Okay. First, we have to know what are the references. Okay. Like this is a cell where I selected. It is under B column and under third row. So that means the cell address is B3. So B3 is a reference. Okay. Like if I click here, so it is on fifth column, fifth row and F column, F5. The reference is F5. And what we directly put, these are called value. See, this is the reference and this is the value. Okay. So when you start formula, always start with equal to, and then you have to give some value or any reference. Like if I want to know that what is 10 plus 2. So I am directly giving the value. I am just doing a simple calculation here. So it will give me a result. This thing I can do with references also. 10 plus 12. So 10, 12 I have written in references. Now I will equal to select that reference. It will be written here. 10 plus sign.
Oh, Sandeep,
yes.
Sandeep, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Can you hear me? Okay, yeah, I can't see your desktop. I can hear you, but I can't see your desktop.
Okay. Let me start again. Okay,
that's better.
So when we are going to start the formula, it is with equal to, plus sign and minus sign. So like when you click any cell, I'm clicking here. So here you can see the cell address like F5. So that means F5 is the reference for this cell. And whatever value is inserted there, it will show to here. So this is the value and this is the reference for the cell. Okay, so in formulas we can use both, be that it is reference, be that it is value. So I will start my formula with equal to, I will insert any value 10, then plus 2, so it will show me the result as 12. I can put the values and with equal to I have to select the references for the calculation like 10 plus 12, B8 plus C8. That means whatever written under the cell, it will be calculated. Okay. So that's how we start the formula with equal to. Same thing you can do with plus also. Directly you gonna do this, it will show you enter. You same thing you can do with minus also, but in minus your value will be converted in negative, your first value will be converted in negative. So it is better if you start your formula with equal to and plus sign only. Now let's talk about operators, mathematical operator. For calculations we use operators. So what are the calculation operator, mathematical operators for the calculation? First is plus, minus. For multiply we use star, for divide we use slash, and for power we use caret. So we use plus, minus, multiply, divide, and power. Let's suppose here we have some value. So if we have to plus, we can use the start the formula with equal to, then we select reference or value, then I add operator, and then I am selecting the value. So mathematical operator, these are the mathematical operator, such as I want to multiply this. So I can use a star for that. So the result will be shown in multiplication. The same you can use for division also, like this reference, backslash, and this one. So the divide value. And if you want to know the power of something, you want to know the power, then you can use like 6^3. So we can use caret, it comes through shift 6. Okay. Now let's go ahead with logical operators. We have logical operator equal to, greater than equal to, less than equal to, and not equal to.
So the result is true or false on these ones, right?
Correct. You know about, you already know about these operators? Do you aware of these
operators? I used it a little bit.
Okay. Greater than equal to, less than equal to, not equal to. So when we have to compare the value, then we use logical operators. Like here I have written some numbers. So if I want to know which number is equal to which number, if I can select the references, that I want to know this H10 is greater than 52 or not. So I will press enter and the result will be generated in true false. When this cell changes its value, I change the value of first cell, so it shows me true because it is now greater than. Likewise, you can use equal to operator. So start with formula with equal to, then select reference, and then I am asking that H10 equal to 50, this I10. So it will show me false because it is not equal to. So when we check with is H10 not equal to, we use less than greater than sign combinedly. Is H10 not equal to I10, so it will give me true value. Likewise, you can use greater than equal to and less than equal to. And greater than equal to, as you know, the value containing the same thing. Like if I compare the reference here, this H13 is greater than this I13, so it will show me false because it is not. But I press greater than or equal to, greater than equal to, it will show me true. So it is combinedly at two conditions. Then we use some of the operators we have for text also. For text we have only one operator, that is concatenate. Thank you. So in through which concatenation operator we do, like I have typed my name in two cells and now I want to combine this first name and last name in single cell. So I can use this operator. So I start the formula with equal to, then select reference, then give this sign ampersand sign concatenation operator, and select another reference, so it will be shown as combined. So I need a space also there. So what I have to do, I will give you space, I will give the space from here. Now we can directly enter the values into the formula, or we can give the references. But if you want to enter any text value, you have to use inverted commas. So in between the inverted commas, I am giving space, because the character I need this space. Then I am applying again the concatenation operator, because after every reference and value, between every reference and value, we need any operator for calculation. So I have given two times this concatenation operator. So it will automatically insert a space between the two values. Now I need Mr. before the value. So in inverted comma, because we are entering text, I am typing Mr. then one space. Space I am giving, because if I don't give space, so there will be not any space. I am combining again with concatenate. Now you can see the effect of that. Okay. So that's how we deal with operators. Now let's go our first formula. In formula bar, you have different types of formulas. Financial is there, logical is there, tax, date, time, lookup and references, math, trigonometry, in more function is statical, engineering, cube, information, lots of functions we are having. So these are predefined calculations which you can use as formula, but the rule applies as same, that you have to start the formula with equal to. So first we start with logical values. Logical formulas works on logical values only. Okay. That's the simplest formula for that is if. Let's suppose there are two values and I want to compare both, that if D17 is greater than 23. So it gives me the result in true and false. So what if formula do? I type if bracket star, then what I need to do here, any logical test. So logical test, we give a condition. So we give a condition that D17 is greater than E17 or not. So it will evaluate the true false value here. After evaluation, I end this condition with comma. Then we go to second parameter, value if true. Means if this condition evaluates true, then what value we are going to show. So I say if it is true, then it should show greater. So we are entering text, so one rule only with inverted comma. Then I am applying comma, and let's give the third parameter, value if false. Means when the formula evaluates the value as false, then what should be displayed. So I am seeing not greater, like this. So I have entered two values here, you can see, and when I press enter, so it is showing me not greater. When it is greater, so it will show greater. So there is a logical test, but we can also give the reference directly where you have put the condition, like this, where I have put the condition already, I can give the reference. So this true false will be taken from this cell, and according to true false, these values will be displayed. Okay. So you can use formula or direct references as well. Let us understand another formula. AND. In AND, let's suppose we have some candidates. We have some candidates and we have conducted an interview here. So in interview there was 3 rounds. Now every evaluator has put the values like yes or no with after passing the round. So for 3 different rounds, here is the result. So now in status or result, I want to show with the formula that whether the candidate has been selected or not. So if we use if formula, we can use lot of formulas together also. We can use formula into formula, that is nested formula. So if we do it by if formula, then see what is the flow for that. We will press equal to, then type if, then first you are evaluating this thing. That's whether round 1 is equal to y or not. If it is y, then in value if true, we will check another value. So we need another if formula for that. So we will type it later, but let's say if it is no, so it should display reject. Okay. Now expand this if formula. If the first condition is true, we will go for second condition, whether it is equal to y or not. If it is equal to y, we have to check one more value here. So we will apply any one more if formula. But if it is a no, then we will reply with rejected. Then the final if, because we have to check only one condition here. So we will put the condition here that this D21 is equal to y or not. So if it is equal to y, so our condition is all the 3 cells should contain y for the candidate selection. So if every cell is containing y, then it will be got selected. Otherwise, in value if false, reject. So we can display the value like that with if formula. You understood how I have applied here?
Oh yes, yes, I done this before. It's called a nested if statement.
Got it. So do you know any easy way for that? Do you know any easy way for that?
Sorry, can you repeat your question?
Do you know the easy
way for that? No, I that's how I did it. I don't know any other way.
So we have AND formula here that will help you in this same scenario. So I will declare the result here. So what is the case with that? what we can do with AND formula, we can give lot of conditions together in AND formula, n number of conditions. So first we will check whether B21 equal to Y or not. Then we will check C21 equal to Y or not. Then we will check this D21 equal to Y or not. Okay. So by default, AND reacts like that if your all condition is true, then AND is going to return true. If one of the condition is false, one or more the condition is false, it will going to return false. For getting true from AND formula, all conditions should return true value. So in this case, every statement will these two will return true because they have Y, but this one will reflect false, so it will give you false like this. So this is how we are going to display the result. Like here it is false, rejected, selected true, false, false.
Okay, so that is easier. That is easier to do that. It's simpler.
Yes, yes. So we can use if formula now. Just reference to this value and just display the result. If there is a true, then it should be true selected. Otherwise, it should display rejected. Okay. So the same result is here. Now we have to combine this formula because we don't want to use two cells for the expected result. So how we are doing that? We can see that we have taken reference of F21 here. So we can replace it by just go here, copy the formula in this cell. Before equal to, then copy, do not take equal to with it. Type Control C for copying and then just select this F21 and Control V, paste. Okay, now drag the result. Now if I press F2 here, so I can see there is no link with this formula, don't have link with it. It is totally dependent on these three cells. Our formula is free now. But let me show you one thing. Now I want to copy this data here with formula. I am using Control C here, then Control V. Okay. So when I click on this value F2, press F2. I can see my reference has been changed. There is no Y in A21. I have not given this this condition with these names. So when we move our data with copy, so we can see the reference always changed. To get rid of this problem, you just, instead of copying the data, you should cut the data. Press Ctrl X and then paste on the target range. So what happens, your reference will not be disturbed. Okay. Is it clear?
Yeah, so you're saying if we cut the data, then the references, it just copies it. The references doesn't change.
Yes, yes. Just if you just cut the data and paste, then the reference will remain same. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. That makes sense. Or is sometimes they just put the dollar sign.
Yes. You are right. I will tell you about dollars also. Now, we have one more formula like AND. We have OR. And let us take a different scenario for that. Let us say these candidates want to open their bank accounts. Okay. So they want, the bank wants some ID proof. Okay. Or you can say driving license or your or you can say your, what is the ID proof there in your area? Here it is, driving license and the social security number like this.
Or passport?
Passport. So the bank wants any one of, if you have any one of the document, then we can open your bank account. Okay. So we will display the result. So I need at least one document for opening the bank account. So with or, if I apply with if, so I need to go then nested if there, but I can do it with or, that it is equal to y and C28 equal to y. So what or do, in or you can put multiple of conditions here, but what or returns, if any of the condition returns true, the or will display true. Okay. Like this.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
And the same thing you can use with if formula. The same thing. Okay. Not okay. Okay. Now, let us take jointly. And then on. So the same bank account wants that, let us state as ID proof and here it is address proof. So in address proof, what is your ration card or what is there? In address proof, electricity bill. Bill and telephone bill. So let's say bank demands you one ID proof and one address proof. Okay. For opening a bank account, at least you should deposit one ID proof, one address proof. So first we need to check the values in between of these two. Then we have two address proofs. So we have a, where we have a choice, there we will use OR formula. So we will use OR formula there. Is B36 equal to Y and C36 equal to Y. Okay. So OR will deliver true if any one of the condition is true. Okay. That is for ID proof. Now for address proof, I will apply same condition in OR as equal to void and E36 equal to void. Okay. Now I drag the value. Now what I am saying that a bank need one ID proof and one address proof means these both of the conditions should return true. Okay. So what we will going to do here? So first condition.
Join all the AND.
Yes. So first condition I have selected, then second condition. Okay. So AND will return true where both the values are true, as you can see. Okay. Now with.
So that's a pretty handy function then.
Correct. Correct. So with if we are going to display the result. So on the basis of this condition, it is going to show OK and not OK. And I'm also telling you that how to break the formula into parts, break the logics into parts, so that you can apply any bigger formula. Okay. Now let us combine formula together. So first this is our final value, and our final value is dependent upon this value. But if we talk about this value, it is dependent upon these two values. So if we talk about these values, so this is dependent on our data. So we have to make like that the value should be dependent on our data, our final formula should be dependent on data. We follow that same copy paste method. Guys, I select this. This is F36. So I copy the formula before equal to. Then I go where I have used this reference F36. So I have used the reference F36 here. I copy the formula here. Then I can see. Okay. F36, enter. So when I click F2 here, so I can see there is no reference of this formula here now. So same we have to do with G36. So we go and copy the formula before equal to and paste it here. Here I have written G36, paste it here, press enter. Now this AND formula is totally free. It is not dependent on this. It is dependent on data only. Now we have to copy full AND formula without equal to. Then we will paste it here, H36, where we have used this reference like this. Okay. Then we will do Control X and paste it here and drag the formula. Now we don't need this much of formula, and you can see the formula is complex and bigger. So this is the secret for making a formula. Okay, making a bigger formula. Till now you understood?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's go ahead with some text formulas. Okay. So in logical formula, if you see, there is three formulas there. This true formula and false formula returns true false only. If you type true, it will return you true like this. So this formula doesn't do anything. We have if error formulas, such as you have applied VLOOKUP and it delivers any error. So you can use the if error formula. Like Here I have typed some values like quantity and rate. So we will forget about quantity and rate. Let's say we have two values and we are going to divide one of them. Okay. We have applied division here. So if this cell is containing zero, then it will return you an error, because this cell can maybe this cell generating values through formula. So what we want to do, that this error message should not display here. Instead of error message, some other thing should be there, or there should be blank only. Like this, we want to program this. So we can use if function as well for identifying error, but we have any predefined function here like if error. After if error, you type your whole formula. After typing whole formula, press comma. Then you have value if error, means when you receive any error in this formula, what is to be done? So I am saying that display this message error. Okay. So when there is a value, then it is okay, and when there is nothing, when there is error, it will show your custom message. Instead of custom message, you can make your cell blank by just putting double inverted commas. Don't give any character between it. It will be remain blank when there is an error. So when there is value, it will display the value, and there is an error, there is no error, but the formula is there. That's how we deal with if logical formulas. Now let us talk about some text formulas. Okay. So in text formula, our first formula is bar text. Like bar text, when you select this formula, so what is this? It will convert your number into words, like 1234. But it converts in Thai language, so it is of no use for us. If you copy this value and put it in Google Translate, you will find the actual value, that it is 1234, but it is in Thai language, so we don't have to use it. So if it is just for knowledge sake, I am telling you. Then we have two more things, char and code. There are two formulas, but we need to understand first what is code. So you may be aware of the term ASCII values. ASCII. If you are not aware, just go there. Go to Google. And type ASCII. ASCII. ASCII table. Or code. So you have site ASCII table. Just open it. Basically it is a table, and every character is numbered, serialized with n number. As you can see, for capital A it has 65. So the 65 is the code for capital A, and you can see for a small a there is a code 97. Okay. So
So the ASCII is under the DEC?
The ASCII is this one.
It's a DEC, under DEC, okay.
Why I am telling you all this? Because when I am entering A, so you can get the ASCII value with your code. Okay, I am taking the reference. So it will display you the ASCII value. If there is small a, it will display you a 97. So let me tell you an interesting one. You have char formula available, and if you deliver this code into char formula, it will return that character again. So if I type A here, so let's make some change. I want to plus 32 into this character, into its code. So you can see in 65 and 97 there is a difference of 32. If I plus, so it is changing my case now. A, B, C, D, the change case. Once a student asked me that we can use January, February, but we can't use ABCD. So he has challenged me to do that. So what I have done, I can do with custom list also. But what I have done, I have typed A here. I have taken char formula here. Then under char formula, I put code formula. And in code formula, I have selected the upper one. And the result will be plus 1. Okay. So when we get the code of above, it will plus 1 in that code and supply to char formula. What will deliver? B. Likewise, we can get A, B, C, D like this. It's a just by use of formula. Then let's move with other formulas. Why I am telling you these formulas? Because we should have knowledge about each and every formula, maximum of formula. It will help you whether you will, when you will get a problem like that. Because we use multiple of formulas to solve a particular problem. Okay, so we can't decide that this formula is important or not. Okay. Now sometimes if you are dealing with ERPs, or you might have seen this, I am typing this first name and then pressing Alt Enter for inserting a new line in same cell. Okay, like this. I have inserted Alt Enter. So if I type here the same stuff, and if I make it as, it will, the new line will be visible only when you press wrap text from here. If you don't do wrap text, the both is looking same. But it is not, because I have applied Alt Enter there. So how to get that, how to judge that? I will use len formula first, L-E-N. So len formula is for identifying the length of the text. So when we see, it is showing me 13, but the downwards it is showing me 12. But the values, when you see the values, you don't find any difference there. So we have a formula for it. Clean. This clean formula clears the unprintable characters into the text. Sometimes you are using VLOOKUP and it is not working, and you are you are confused why it is not working, what is there, the value is right. So that maybe that the reason is there is something non-printable character. So to remove that non-printable character, we use clean formula. Clean formula. So I have given the reference of above one, then I have entry, and now check the length of the cell. It is 12. So now it is okay. Let's suppose sometimes when we use ERP, these kind of problem occur. But sometimes we have to deal with spaces, like blank spaces. Like there is a space before Sandeep and after Sandeep there is a space. And between is there a space. So the between one I have need, but the right or left spaces I don't want. Let us check the length first. It is 15. So there is a formula trim. If I select this, so what trim will do, trim will remove the blank spaces from the starting and the ending of the text. Now let us check the length. It is 39. Okay. So this trim formula helps you to trim the spaces. This text formula you can use for manipulating data, your data. But you have large reports and some problems are there. So you can use this these formulas for manipulating data. Now, how to deal with cases? For change case, like I have written everything in a small case. So when I need to change in uppercase, I can use upper formula and select this reference, dragging that. Okay, now it is converted in uppercase. We have lower formula. I am choosing this one reference. So it will convert everything in lowercase. We have a proper formula. With the help of proper formula, it will show me the first character of every word will be capital. Okay, so these three formula we use for case change. Then we have let's suppose we want to replace some data into text. Let's replace something like I have typed wrong name of yours. So, but I want to make it correct by formula. So what I'll do, what I need to do here, I need to replace this U with E and U. So what I can do, we have two formulas here. First is replace. Okay. So in replace, you have to select the old text first. This is one. Then the starting position, you should count the values, letters from here, me 1, 2, 3, 4, and count the space also 5, 6, 7, and 8. From 8 we need to start. And how many characters we are going to replace? We are going to replace this U. So only one character. The new text will be EU. Okay. Is it your correct name? So we are doing this.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's how it's spelled.
Yes.
No, handy. Handy little
Huh? So we can use one more formula for that. That is substitute. In substitute, it is a simple formula, and first formula we need to do lot of countings there, but here you just have to define the thing. Just select the text, then the old text means the old text is U, and the new text is EU. So it will replace every U with EU. Okay. So both do the same thing, but there is a difference in this substitute formula. Like, so in my name there is double O, I want to replace with double E. Okay, let's say I want to replace only second O. So I can use with substitute formula, select text, old text is O, new text will be E. Here we have an optional. There you can see there is a bigger brackets there, so that parameter is optional. So either you give or not, there is no difference. So if you give the instance number, means it is the first one O you want to change, or second one O, like this. So I want to change the second O. So I will type 2 here. So I can see the difference. There is second O changed. But if I do not give any instance number there, it will change every O with E. Okay. So there is slight difference.
Oh, listen, Microsoft thought about everything.
Huh?
They well, it's a very well designed program, but they thought about every conceivable problem to fix it.
Yes, yes. Now, let's suppose you want to find something. You want to match values in two columns. So what you will use? Equal to this one is equal to this one. Okay, B2 is equal to C2. So it will return me true. But if I want some exact result, see, I don't want that. I want that it should be case sensitive. If it is written here the same, if the case is not same, means it is in lower case and it is in upper case, so it should display false. So we can use the exact function. You can type exact, click the first one, and the second one. If it is not exact, then it will show you false. But if there is same case, then it will display you true. Okay. Now, like, if you want to find some value, so you have two formulas there. First is find, in find we type the character within text of the find text what we are going to find in which we are going to find within text. This is an optional starting number, but we are not going to give now. So it is delivering me an error. If I type small a here, so it will returning me 2. 2 means it is available, it is the second letter of the text. So I don't want that the result should be case sensitive. So we have one find formula and parallelly we have search formula. So in search formula I type capital A and within text, so it will give me the correct result whatever the case will be. Yeah. Okay. Case of the character. Now let's take a scenario here. A scenario in which I have few names like 3, the big names, so there are some persons. So I want to draw the first name here, then middle name here, and the last name here in these columns. So what formula I can use? For getting the first name means getting the value from the left, you use left formula. Okay. In left you have to define text and then the number of characters, that how many characters do you want. So I will count my first name here, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, so 7 characters I want. There it is. Likewise you can get the last name also, means the value from the right, so we will use right formula. So I will count from the ending, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 characters are there. So I will select this and put 5 here. So last time is here. Then we need middle name. So we can use mid formula for that. In mid formula, it is like a replace we have done. So you just supply the text. Start number which one it is, 7 characters are there and 8th one is space and the 9th one middle name is start with 9th letter. I will type here 9. Then how many characters I want from 9th? From 9th, 10th, so I have to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 characters I want further. So I will type 5. Okay, so that's how we get this first name, mid name, last name. But we don't have much time, such as we have bigger list, so that will be a problem. So what I am going to do, I am just copying the formula. So you can see it is not matching, because every time I don't have to get the 7 characters. So any predefined values I can't use. So I need to automate the formula, make it dynamic. So what are the things we needed here? We need here first space, then second space, then full length. Now what is the logic, how I am going to do it? If you get the first space from here with the help of find function, so you can take minus 1, like first space is here on 2. If I use minus 1, 2 minus 1, so I will get my first name, and if I supply the value here. So let's do it. So we, what function we will use? Find. Find. In inverted commas, you will supply space, then comma, then find what within text. This will be the text. Enter. So it will give you the first space and second space as well. First space. Yeah. Now for second space, we will use the same function. We will do the same thing, but what we are going to do, we will specify the start number, because we need to find the first space. So we, if we give the, as we are finding the first space on 2, if we give the start number as 2, it will find the space on 2 and it will be remain at 2. So what I am going to do, 2 plus 1, okay. So this first space plus 1. After the first space, I am instructing the formula to search for this another space. So I will get the second space. So here it is. And for length, we have length formula. Length formula. So I am applying the same. Now let's automate it. So in left function, I am going to give first space. First space minus 1. Because here is one character only, so first space I have selected minus 1. First name here. Then for middle name, what I am going to supply, the start num will be the first space plus 1. So first space plus 1. Then how many characters I want? I want second space minus first space minus 1. So this will be the logic format. Then for the right, what I am going to do, length minus second space. I will type here length minus second space. Okay. Here is the result. If I copy the formula down, so I can get the same result, the perfect result. Now let us make the formula into one. So find is directly accessing to this data, and this find is accessing this one. So I need to copy this find. So here I can see that in most of the functions I have used this G file. Okay, so if I want to replace in one go, so how I am going to do? I will select this all, then I will press Ctrl F, this find and replace, go to replace, type G file should be replaced with this formula. Here you will press replace all. So you can see there are four replacements, and you can see the formula changed automatically. And in second space also, because we have taken the reference of first space also. So now it is free. every formula is independent. So we have replaced the first space, then second space. So for second space, I am copying this formula before equal to, and I am replacing the H5 with this formula. I will select, if I go to replace, so H5 will be replaced with this formula. I type replace all. So two replacement done. Then this length formula. So wherever it is used, I5. Okay, because it is in under I5 cell. This formula replace. So one replacement done. So now you can see the full formula. This is the left function, mid function, and the right function. So they are complex formula inserted automatically, and you don't need to bother about it. If I copy the formula, I can see the result. But now look into the values when there will not be every time 3-digit values. Means there will not be every time first name, middle name and last name. Let's suppose there is only first name and last name. It can be there, and somebody can have a single name also, only first name. So how I am going to do, I am typing the first name and then copying the formula. So my formula is generating first name perfectly but giving error in middle name and last name. Okay, so this is a last name, so I need to get the last name. So but there is an error. I told you one formula, if error, if you get the errors here. So what I will do, I don't need any middle name here, so I will apply if error formula. In values is there every, the whole formula, then press comma and give the value if error. If there is an error, it should display blank. Okay, the first error solved. Now let's come to the second error, last name, because we need last name here. So we will apply the same if error function here also, but if this formula gives an error, then we should display, we should apply the another formula, which is write, the text will be this one. I am applying the formula in one go. Okay, try to understand. Right. Now, number of, how many numbers of characters? Total length minus first space. So it will be like length, I am taking the replace, minus first space with find, I will get the first space. So now you got the second name here. Okay, but somebody can have initials only, only first name. So I copy the formula here. So I am getting a value error here also. What I'll do, I will apply if error also here. If it is generating an error, it should display this value only, this referential value only, no calculation. Okay, and if it is generating an error, so again one more if error in ending init blank. Now okay, now let's copy the formula down, but we are getting a zero there. So if there is no value, it is giving me the zero. So what I am going to do, I am just copying the formula and putting the old formula into if condition. If this formula gives me the zero, then it should display blank, otherwise this formula to be done. Okay. Now you can see each and every formula is perfect now. Okay. If you type single digit name, it is okay. If you give double names, then it is okay. It is coming under first name, last name. And if you are giving three digit names, it is giving you the result. And if you do not give any value, it will display blank. So that's how we deal with text formulas. Okay, is it clear now?
Okay, yeah, it's pretty straightforward, the text.
It is somewhere complex, I guess. So I have told you about number formatting also. So one formula is there, a number formatting in custom formatting. I have told you that if you want to change the visibility of the data, so you use custom formatting. But if you want to change the reality of the data, you can use one formula here. Like there was, I am typing any check number, and through the format I am giving this 6 times 0 there. So now it is preceded with 0, but there is no 0. So there is a formula from which you can get exactly the same value. So I just make it general and use the text formula. First I need to select the reference value, and then in format text I will give the same format under inverted commas, 6 times 0. Okay, I got the result. Now I'm copying and paste as values. So you can see the result of the value. Let's see. You can do it with dates also. Like I have typed some date here. I need month only, month and year only. So I can use text formula, take this value, and the format is MMM-YY. So this format I want. So it will change the text into that. If you copy paste, you will get these values actually. Okay. Then we have, sometimes we type numbers and text, there is number and text. Some text is there, some number. So we have one T formula and N formula, which extract, if we apply T formula, so wherever there was a number, it will not display anything, and if there is text, it will display the value. Okay. The N formula shows you the same with numbers, but wherever it find text, it will display as zero. It is displaying the number, but giving you the zero. This zero, if you don't want the zero, you can use if formula for that. That if it is giving you a zero, it should display blank line. Okay. This TN formula, you can use according to. So these are the text formulas, logical formulas, and formula calculation operators was today's topic. Okay, I need you may.
Okay, yeah, that's good.
I think you need a lot of practice for that, so you have enough time for practice.
Okay, yeah, I'll practice it.